Guru Ganeshabhyam Namaha. After the demons Madhu and Kaidabha were destroyed by Mahavishnu at the end of a battle that lasted for 5,000 years with the aid of Mahamaya Parashakti, Devi told the Trimurtis, "Now you can do your own duties of creation, sustenance and dissolution without any fear. The demons have been destroyed." Brahma told Devi, "But we don't have the power to do this. Where will I do the creation? It is water everywhere. There is no earth. There are no panchabhutas. There are no trigunas. There are no tanmatras. There are no indriyas. Without these, how will I start creation? I need all these to create." Devi smiled. At the time, a divine Vimana appeared. Devi said, "You all get into this Vimana. I will show you something." After they occupied the beautiful Vimana, it started rising up. The Vimana reached a place which was not filled with water. It was a beautiful garden with all kinds of fruit-bearing trees. It was not just a garden. There were mountains, rivers, birds singing, peacocks dancing. There were people there. Men, women, houses, ponds, lakes. There were palaces, yagashalas. The Trimurti started wondering. The creation has not happened. Brahma is supposed to create. He had just told Devi that he doesn't have the material even to create. But then where did this come from? Who created all these? There was a king who was coming out from a palace and he was about to leave for gaming. That means this was there for quite some time, not recently created. The Vimana rose up. They reached another place. There they saw Kamadhenu under the shade of Parijata tree. All the Apsaras were there. There they saw Indra and Indrani and all the other Devas also. This must be Surga. But then who created Surga? Even Surga is meant to be created by Brahma only. This Surga, who has created? Vimana rose up again and reached Brahmaloka. There they saw Brahma and Sabha. All the Vedas were there in the Brahma Sabha. Brahma was sitting there in his Sabha, in Brahmaloka. Seeing this, Vishnu and Shiva asked Brahma, who was with them in the Vimana, "Then who are you? If that is Brahmaloka and that is Brahma, then who are you?" Brahma said, "I don't know. If that is Brahma, then I don't know who I am. I am completely lost here." In the same way, the Vimana went to Vaikuntha. They saw Vishnu there, another Vishnu. Then the Vimana went to Kailasa. They saw another Shiva there. The Trimurti sitting inside the Vimana just couldn't understand what was going on. The Vimana rose up again and reached the shore of an ocean of nectar, an ocean of amrita. There were tall waves in that ocean. Even the shore was beautiful with all kinds of trees and ponds and streams and waterfalls, birds, bees, everything. Then they realized that it was not a shore. They were in an island in the middle of the ocean of nectar. At the center of that beautiful island, there was a throne. Not the regular kind of throne. It was more like a bed, like the divan that we have these days. But fully studded with precious gemstones, diamonds, rubies, pearls, sapphires. There were silk clothes spread on the divan, resembling rainbow, of different colors. And on that was seated a beautiful divine woman. She was seated there on that Paryanka. It is called Paryanka, the bed-like throne. She was wearing a garland made of red flowers. Her clothes were red. Red appears to be her favorite color. She was wearing red sandal paste. Not the regular sandal, red sandal. She was as brilliant as innumerable lightnings. Lakshmi Devi is supposed to be the most beautiful. But this Devi was 100 times more beautiful than Lakshmi Devi. She had a pleasant smile on her face. She was holding Ankusha and Pasha on her upper hands. And her lower hands were held in Abhaya and Varada Mudra, offering protection and blessing. The Trimurtis could hear constant chanting of Shakti Bija, Shakti Bija Akshara. Hrim, 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 Hrim. A lot of beautiful maidens were serving her. They were at her service. The Trimurtis were wonderstruck. Now who is this? From distance they could see that her form kept on changing. Sometimes as they saw it now, then with thousands of eyes and thousands of hands. Lord Vishnu said, this must be Jagadamba, this must be Mahamaya, this must be the Adiparashakti, the mother of all Vedas, Veda Janani, Moola Prakriti, who absorbs everything into herself at the time of Pralaya. And again, manifests all of them at the time of creation. We must have done some real Punya in the past to get her darshana like this. Nobody gets to see her. The Trimurtis offered pranamas to her again and again after getting down from the Vimana. As soon as they got down, all three became women. The Trimurtis became women, wearing beautiful dress and ornaments. They approached near her. And there they saw the most surprising, most fascinating, most wonderful sight that anybody has ever seen. In the nails of the toes of Devi, they could see the entire array of multitude of universes with 14 worlds in each one of them. Everything was there. Trillions of galaxies, all the devas, all the asuras, all beings, movable, immovable, all objects, mountains, rivers, everything was there in the nails of her toes. Even what they went through, the demons appearing, troubling Brahma, Mahavishnu, eliminating them, everything they could see there in the nails of her toes. That is who Mahamaya is. That is her greatness. Jagadambayai Namaha.
Yajnanishre Kadamankarma.